can climate change cause wars? Well, the answer might surprise you. In 2014, the Department of Defense categorized climate change as a threat multiplier that could make future conflicts both more frequent and more deadly. Multiple academic papers have implicated a climate change-fueled drought in the Syrian civil war, and just last year, presidential candidate Bernie Sanders said,
"Climate change is directly related to the growth of terrorism, and you're going to see all kinds of international conflict."
But there's no way it can be that easy, right? It would be crazy to blame an entire civil war on drought or rising temperatures. So what can we say about the relationship between climate and conflict? Think about it like this. Let's say you're driving a car. The likelihood of getting in an accident depends on a lot of things. How good your driving is, how good all the other drivers are, your state of mind, whether or not you're texting. But the environment can also throw a few speed bumps your way. For example, the likelihood of an accident definitely shoots up if the roads are icy. Now, icy roads don't guarantee a crash. But if you're not a great driver to begin with, and the roads are icy, and you're in a hurry and made more anxious by all the other sliding cars on the roads, there's a decent chance you might. And if you do, which factor is most to blame? It's very hard to say. There's no way of knowing that this time the environment made you crash. But we can say that the environment increased the likelihood of your fender getting real friendly with a tree. And that's not a bad way of thinking about how heat and drought relate to aggression and conflict. A recent analysis of dozens of studies calculated that, for a certain spike in temperatures compared to average, the risk of conflict increases by more than 10%. And that's not only true for massive events like war. Similar relationships seem to hold for other violent events, like assault, homicide, and domestic violence. But why? It's understandable how in a farming society, for example, something like drought could add to the kind of economic and social stress that might lead to conflict. If crop yields are your main source of income, drought can mean desperation. It's a little less obvious how rising temperatures alone lend themselves to violence, especially in places like cities where incomes don't necessarily depend directly on crops. But temperature increases have been found to correlate with violence in US cities and have been documented in places like Chicago, Minneapolis, Baltimore, Phoenix, Dallas, Charlotte, and St. Louis. We know that higher temperatures lend themselves to discomfort. What some psychologists have already shown is that this discomfort can lend itself to mistaking a totally benign situation for an aggressive one. And if you think someone is threatening you, you're more likely to respond in kind. Even baseball pitchers are more likely to hit batters on hotter days without even realizing that their actions are more aggressive or retaliatory than usual. All this research hints at how climate change might augment future conflict. In the United States, for example, rising temperatures could mean an added $5 to $20 billion to the cost of violent crime in the US alone. And researchers at Stanford and Berkeley project that in Africa alone, we could see 393,000 additional deaths in combat by 2030. This doesn't mean that climate change will cause World War III, but it does mean we need to be more careful about how we act in and think about a world that's hotter, drier, and maybe a little quicker to the trigger.